In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a set of interface buttons. Let's add a reference image. I'll post a link in the description below. I'll use a cube to create a button mesh. Tab, to go to edit mode, and 3, to face select. I have just selected a face and typed G, to move the face to match the reference image. Let's select the top face. We could type, I, as in India to extrude inward, but we need to reset all transforms before doing that. It's not mandatory, but if we change the shape of a mesh and try to extrude a face inward, sometimes the scaled area size is not even. To reset all transforms, we need to go to edit mode, and press Ctrl, A. Select reset all transforms. E, to extrude downward. In order to match the reference image, we need beveled edges. This is one way to do so. Basically, I'm selecting the outer and the inner edges and I'll be beveling with Ctrl, B, but this won't work well. Once we have the triangular shape on the corners, the top face will break up. The unknown line in the middle indicates the face is now broken. Let's undo. I'll show you a better way. This time, we'll press Ctrl, 3, to subdivide and sharpen up the edges by pressing Ctrl, R, to add multiple loop cuts. There is our main mesh. Let's work on the next mesh. I'll use a subdivided cube, and add loop cuts the same way. S, and Z, to scale in the Z axis. Let's add the materials. This looks good, but I'll use a gradient material instead. Let's rotate the gradient on the Y axis. I'll apply all modifiers, select both meshes, and Ctrl J to join them. Shift D to duplicate. I'll add a ground plane, set up the render scene, and use the sky texture. Let's disable SunDisk. We won't get a shadow like that once we disable it. This is the best method to render interface meshes. I'll use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.